Want to speak real Turkish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at TurkishClass101.com.
Merhaba, ben Seda.
Hello,
I'm Seda. Welcome to TurkishClass101.com. Today we'll talk about ordinal numbers, which are like first, second, third in English. So before we start, let's remember the regular numbers. We have lessons about regular numbers. If you don't know them, if you didn't study before, please study the numbers, regular numbers. Then come back to this lesson. So this will be just a reminder, so I'll say it quickly. So let's start counting together. Do you remember the first one? One, bir, iki, üç, dört, beş, altı, yedi, sekiz, dokuz, on. One more time. Bir, iki, üç, dört, beş, altı, yedi, sekiz, dokuz, on. So these are basic numbers. And as a rule, to make the regular numbers into ordinal numbers, we add suffix inci. So for example, for one, bir, we add inci. Bir inci, birinci, meaning the first. But you know that we have Turkish vowel harmony rules, so you need to study that before adding any suffix to a Turkish word, because that main rule decides which kind of vowel will go into the suffix. So in this case, we can say inci, we can add inci, ıncı, uncu, or üncü. So we have four basic suffixes for making ordinal numbers. So for example, for bir, bir inci, for three, üç, üç, üncü, for five, beş, inci, for dokuz, nine, dokuz, uncu. So you can hear the sounds, they follow the harmony rules. But I know it's a little bit complicated, but we have a lot of out of rule things for ordinal numbers. In Turkish, I told this before, in Turkish two vowels can't come together, like ana, ene, they can't come together. If there are words with two vowels together, they probably came from another language, as in I gave this example, as in saat means clock or time, which came from Arabic. Other than that, Turkish words can't be two vowels together, so we add buffer letters in between. If we are gonna add a suffix starting with a vowel and we have a word ending with a vowel, we need to add a buffer letter in between. These buffer letters are ye, she, se, ne. Let me check if I forget one. Yeah, no. So the I have a trick for you. Actually, we have a word yaşasın. Hey, it means like hey, like something like that. Hooray or hooray, hey, it means that yaşasın, hey, you're so happy and you're celebrating. And when you take the vowels out of that verb, yaşasın, ye, şe, se, and ne are left. So these are the buffer letters. Maybe you can remember like that. And so this was it. And we have other kind of out of rules, out of rule numbers with dört, four. Besides vowel harmony rules, we have consonant rules as well. Some hard sound consonants get softened, or some soft sound vowels harden sometimes. So in dört, t is hard. So when we add the suffix Üncü
here.
Dört. Üncü.
We make the tea D. So we can say it easily. That's the actually only reason. Dörtüncü, it's hard to say with th, with R and T and U, like it's all over here. Dörtüncü, it's hard to say. So we may we soften it. Like dördüncü. Dördüncü. Instead of dört, when we add the suffix, we say dörd with D. So don't worry, I will say all the numbers one by one. I'm just talking about the rules now. So we have two more out of rule thing. One is set with seven, the other is with six. I have to check. One is with seven, the other is with six. Seven is yedi. It ends with E already, like I, the letter I. So, you know, we need to add the suffix inci. So instead of add the suffix inci and put a buffer letter, we thought we already have E over there. So we need to assume that that's the part of the suffix. So we just add inci. So we make yedinci. Just we drop the E from the suffix, we add it to the yedi. Ye, din, ci. Ye, din, ci. And it's the same with the six. So we have altı as six. Altı. Instead of adding ıncı, we drop ı, because we already have the ı over in the six. And we make altıncı. Okay, now you know all about the rules. Let's say the numbers together, okay? Birinci. Birinci. First. Birinci. İkinci. İkinci. Second. İkinci. Üçüncü. Üçüncü. Third. Üçüncü. Dördüncü. Dördüncü. Fourth. Dördüncü. Beşinci. Beşinci. Fifth. Beşinci. Altıncı. Altıncı. Altıncı. The sixth. Altıncı. Yedinci. Yedinci. Seventh. Yedinci. Sekizinci. Sekizinci. Eighth. Sekizinci. Dokuzuncu. Dokuzuncu. Ninth. Dokuzuncu. Onuncu. Onuncu. Onuncu. Tenth. Okay, that's it. That's from 1 to 10. And let's say it a little bit faster together. Birinci, ikinci, üçüncü, dördüncü, beşinci, altıncı, yedinci, sekizinci, dokuzuncu, onuncu. That's it, guys. And before I go, I want to give you a little bit cultural insight about something about ordinal numbers. It's not about ordinal numbers, but there's a sentence about ordinal numbers. So I'm gonna say the sentence, then I will explain what it is in our culture. Birinci cemre havaya, ikinci cemre suya, üçüncü cemre toprağa. It literally means that the first cemre means like fire, emerald, the residue from a fire, something like that. It comes from Arabic. So it's something like the first fire to the air, the second fire to the water, and the third fire to the earth, to the soil. So why we use this? We have specific times. This cemre, this fire, is a it lets us know that the spring is coming. So I think there are different opinions about where this belief coming from, but the one I like is about shamanic beliefs. Like the cemre, the fire, actually this when you look at the skies and some stars, when they are a little bit far away, the wavelengths little bit longer, the stars looks reddish, so they look like burning coal, burning fire, something like that. And when they are on the sky on those specific days, that it says the it tells the time. Actually, when you look at the sky and watch the stars, you can tell what time is it, the month, the season. You can tell a lot by looking at the stars. So they look at the star and they see those stars and they say, the spring is coming. And when you see the first one, they say it, the fire falls to the air and it warms the air. Then the second star, second fire, falls into the water and the waters get, you know, warmer. And the third one falls into the earth, to the soil, and it warms the soil, and then spring is here. I really like it, and every year we say that sentence to let us know that spring is coming. So that's it, guys. I hope you liked the lesson. Please leave some comments, and you know, I don't know if you are confused about the numbers or the rules. Please leave some comments, and I will see you next time. Bye. Görüşürüz.
Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.